ශ්‍රී ලංකාව තුළ දෘෂ්ටි සේවය වූ ගුණාත්මක භාවය, වෘත්තීය භාවය, අනන්‍යතාවය, ගරුත්වය, නිවැරදි ක්‍රමවේදය, නූතන තාක්ෂණික දායකත්වය මහජනතාවට ලබා දීමේ මහඟු අරමුණ ඇතුවයි අයිකියා අධ්‍යාපන ආයතනයේ ඇරඹුණේ. එම අධ්‍යාපන ආයතනයේ තවත් සුවිශේෂී කඩේමක් හිතවත් ඔබ හැම සම්බන්ධ කරගනිමින් මේ කඩේම ජයග්‍රහණය කරන්නට බලාපොරොත්තු වෙමින්ද සුහසක් පිරිස සම්බන්ධ කරගනිමින් අප බලාපොරොත්තු වෙන්නේ ආරම්භන්න මේ සම්මානීය සැඳවරුව.
Starting with our chief guest here at the ICAR 2016, the convocation and inauguration, please welcome Dr. Jayasundar Bhandara, the Director General of Ministry of Health. Our guest of honor, Dr. Amir Bialfis, Consultant Eye Surgeon of the National Eye Hospital Colombo. Our special guest, Mr. Wajir Pereira, Director, Tertiary and Vocational Education Commission. Dr. Veera Kumaradasan, Consultant Eye Surgeon. Dr. Aishwanta Paris, Consultant Eye Surgeon. Dr. Asela Abedira, Community Ophthalmologist, National Coordinator, Mission 2020. Dr. Vasantha Gambage, Consultant Eye Surgeon. Dr. Amir Jayasekhar, Mr. Thimna Jayasingha, Mr. S. Gayan Panditan, Mr. Sandurwan Alves, Optometrist Nishantha Jayasekhar, Chairman, Sidon Council of Optometrists, Optometrist Dambika Deshapriya, Chairperson ICAR, Optometrist Naresh Pradhan, the Program Director ICAR, Mr. Jayasekhar, the Past President, Organization of Professional Association, Optometrist Prabha Sirwardhana, the Past Chairperson, ICAR Optometric Association, Optometrist Suranga D. Silva, Registrar ICAR, Optometrist Nisansala Fernando, Treasurer ICAR, Optometrist Prasad Gomez, Director, Community ICAR, Optometrist Mahanam, Director, ICAR Network, Optometrist N. Arun, Director, ICAR Optometric Association, Optometrist M. P. Silva, the honorary member, ICAR Optometric Association, and Mr. Chanak Jayasingha, Chairman, Organization of Ophthalmic Optician. Ladies and gentlemen, lighting of the oil lamp and giving the traditions of Sri Lanka.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. The light of this very special ICAR for enlightening the lives of everyone. And now we'd like to call upon the members of the head table to take your respective seats, starting with our chief guest, Dr. Amir D. Alphys, the consultant eye surgeon, College of Ophthalmologists, National Eye Hospital, Colombo. Our guest of honor, Dr. Meera Kumar Das, consultant eye surgeon. Our special guest, Mr. Vajra Pereira, Director, Tertiary and Vocational Education Commission. Optometrist Nishant Jayasekhar, Chairman, Ceylon Council of Optometrists and Optist. We'd like to call upon Optometrist Dambika Deshapriya, Chairperson, ICAR, and Optometrist Naresh Pradhan, the Program Director, ICAR. And we have all of you taking your respective seats on the table.
ප්‍රධාන වේදිකාවට සම්භාවනීය අමුත්තන්ට ඇරුම් කරමින් අප සූදානම් වන්නේ තවත් විශේෂ කටයුත්තකට. අද මේ ශාලාව තුළ සිටින ඔබ සියලු දෙනාම පහේ රටේ දැක්ම වෙනුවෙන්, රටේ ආලෝකය වෙනුවෙන්, රටේ දෙනෙත් වෙනුවෙන් තමන්ගේ කැපවීම, වැයවීම, දායකත්වය ලබා දුන් පිරිසක්. ඒ නිසා ඒ අභිමානයේ හිතේ තියාගෙන අප සියලු දෙනාටම ඇරුම් කරනවා ජාතික ගීය හා සම්බන්ධ වෙන ලෙස. සහසම්බන්ධ වෙමින් මේ සංදේශය ගත කරන්න ලැබීම වාසනාවක් වන්නේ. දුෂාන් මේ දෘෂ්ටි සේවයට වගකීමක් ඒ වගේ මේක විශිෂ්ටත්වයක් එහි තිබෙන සියලුම මනසිරිතයන් ස්පර්ශ කරමින් නව දැක්මක් ලබා දෙන ආයතනය තමයි අයිකෑ කියන අධ්‍යාපන ආයතනය. මේ ආයතන සමග සහ සම්බන්ධ වෙමින් කෙරෙන මේ කටයුත්ත අද දවසේ සාර්ථක කටයුත්තක් වේවා යන ප්‍රාර්ථනය ඇතිව අභාරම්භ කරමු මේ සම්මාන සංග්‍රහය.
In fact, impossible is just a mere word thrown around by small people who find it quite easy to live with this world rather than the powers that they have within them to explore what has been offered to them. Impossible is something to do with our mindset. It is not something permanent. Impossible is not a declaration. It is just a dare. At the end, impossible is nothing. Today, we have gathered here to richly celebrate and of course, reward a group of dynamic people like you all who thought that impossible is nothing at the end. That's why you all have gathered here to be celebrated. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to ICAR 2016, the convocation and the inauguration. At the very outset, it gives me great pleasure to give you all just a glimpse of what ICAR is all about. ICAR Institute was founded way back in the year 2007 as a school of optometry. The institute got expanded its curriculum and clinical program to reflect the changing demands of the contemporary optometry. The practices as well as the expansion and the upcharges did not limit the institute itself. Thus, it also reflected in all levels of eye care professionals and the other organization, those dealing with optometry. Today, the Eye Care Institute conducts different levels of optician and optometry programs to cater the demands of the country. Further, ICAR provides the largest network of optometry programs with the use of its past students. So once again, a warm welcome to all of you to ICAR 2016, the convocation and inauguration.
හොඳයි එසේනම් අප තවත් වැඩි කතා මොකටදනේ මේ වගේ සුන්දර සංදයාවකට විශේෂයෙන්ම ඔබ සම්මානයට ඇගෙන දුෂාන් කිව්වා වගේ කල නොහැකි කිසිවක් නැති බව ජීවිතයේ තමන්ගේ අත්දැකීමෙන් ජීවිතයේ තමන් අත්විඳපු දෙයින් අනිත් අයට ලබා දුන්න ඔබ සියලු දෙනාම සම්මානයට පාත්‍ර කරන්නට අප සූදානම් ඒ සඳහා ප්‍රථම අදියරට යොමු වන්නටයි මේ සූදානම ඇගීම් සංකේත පිරිනැමීමයි මේ සිදුවන්නේ
Right, ladies and gentlemen, they say that the greatest teacher is not necessarily the one who does the greatest things, but the one who gets all the students to do awesome greatest things in the world. Eye Care Institute is also blessed with not just one greatest teacher, but a team of such great teachers who have been a true inspiration to all of you to achieve all these greater heights. And now it's time to present a token of appreciation to the members of the faculty, the panel of teachers. To do the honors, would like to call upon the chairperson of ICAR, optometrist Dambika Deshapriya, along with the program director of ICAR, optometrist Naresh Pradhan.
මේ ගෞරවනීය දෙපළතින් අද ඇගීමට ලක්වන්නේ ඔබේ ඇගීම හරි විශේෂයි මොකද ඔබ ජීවිත කාලය පුරාම උපයෝ දේවන්නේ මේ අධ්‍යාපනයේ මේ සේවයේ නිසා ඔබට ලැබෙන ඇගීම වෙනුවෙන් අප ගෞරවයෙන් ආරාධනා කරන මුල්ම පුද්ගලයාට ආරාධිත දේශක අශිෂල වෛද්‍ය අමිනද සිල්වා වෛද්‍යතුමා අක්ෂිශාල විශේෂඥ වෛද්‍ය මෙරිනා කුමාරදාස මහත්මිය ඔබට මේ දත්මේ ගෞරවණීය ඇරයුම අක්ෂිශාල විශේෂඥ වෛද්‍ය ආයුෂ්මන්ත පීරිස් නැගතුමනි ඔබතුමාටයි මේ ගෞරවණීය ඇරයුම ජාතික සම්බන්ධීකාරක ප්‍රජා ආරක්ෂා විශේෂඥ වෛද්‍ය අසේන අබේදී මැතිතුමනි ඔබට මගේ දායකත්වයක් අවශ්‍යයි අක්ෂි රෝහල කොළඹ අක්ෂි ශාලේ විශේෂඥ වෛද්‍ය වසන්ත ගමගේ වැටතුමනි ඔබතුමත්
වයි හිත යන පැතිකඩ ඉගෙන හිතේ
අද විශාලාන්ත සිසුදවන ඔබ අනිවාර්යයෙන්ම ඇගීමට පාතු විය යුතු කෙනෙක් අසපිටබල කාය විචේදන සහ බෞද්ධ වේදයේ පිළිබඳ විශේෂඥ දේශක වෛද්‍ය අමිල ජයසේකර මහත්මයාට ආරාධනා කරනවා ජෛව රසායන විද්‍යාව හා සූත්‍ර ජීව විද්‍යාව පිළිබඳ දේශක කිරණ ජයසිංහ මහත්මෙනි ඔබතුමාට මේ ඇරයුම මේ ඇදීම සඳහා ඖෂධ වේදයේ සහ සාමාන්‍ය ඖෂධ පිළිබඳ දේශක ඥානපන්විත මහත්මෙනි ඔබතුමත් අද දින ගෞරවයට පාත්‍ර වෙනවා රසායන විද්‍යාව පිළිබඳ දේශක සඳරුව නයිස් මහත්මෙනි ඔබතුමාට මේ ඇරයුම ඉංග්‍රීසි පිළිබඳ දේශක උපාලි චන්දුගුප්ත මැතිතුමන්ටයි මේ ඇගයුම ලබා ගන්න ලෙස ආරාධනා කරන්නේ අක්ෂි ශල්‍ය විශේෂඥ වෛද්‍ය වත්සලා ගමගේ මහත්මිය ඔබතුමිය සිටිනවා නම් මේ ශාලාව තුළ ඔබත් අනිවාර්යෙන් මේ ඇගයීමට අදාළ තැනැත්තියක් අක්ෂි ශල්‍ය වෛද්‍ය විශේෂඥ වෛද්‍ය ධනපාල මැතිතුමනි ඔබතුමාගේ පැමිණීම අපේක්ෂා කරනවා රසායන විද්‍යාව පිළිබඳ දේශක මංජුල තන්ත්‍රීගේ මැතිතුමනි ඔබතුමාත් අවශ්‍යයි.
Right, thank you very much to our presenters. And now it's time to present the diplomas in optometry. Would like to call upon Dr. Amila Diyalis. Alright, before we present the diploma in optometry, we would like to call upon the chairperson of iCare, optometrist Dhammika Deshapriya, to declare open iCare 2016, the convocation and inauguration.
Good afternoon. Honorable Dr. Amila Diyalis, Consultant Eye Surgeon, College of Ophthalmologist, Mr. Vadri Pereira, Director TVEC, Dr. Meena Kumar Das, Consultant Eye Surgeon, Dr. Aismatha Pilis, Consultant Eye Surgeon, Dr. Asila Abidire, National Coordinator for Vision 2020, Dr. Amila Jayasekar, Mr. Thirina Jayasingha, Member of other organizations, distinguished guests, parents and family members of our students, faculty and staff, friends from media, students and my dear graduate students. On behalf of iCare Institute and iCare Optometric Association and on my own behalf, I welcome you all to the iCare 2016 iCare for Community Inauguration and Convocation of iCare Institute. I hereby declare the convocation started.
Dushan, Obat, Mamat, Apa Dedinam. ඓතිහාසික පිළිබඳව මෙහි තියෙන වටිනාකම පිළිබඳව මෙහි අරමුණ පිළිබඳව මෙහි තිබෙන සමාජ සත්කාරය පිළිබඳව යම් කිසිවක් කතා කළා. හැබැයි ඒ ප්‍රමාණවත් නැහැ කියලා මට හිතෙනවා. මොකද මේ බලදරන මේ සඳහා තමන්ගේ උරපත ලබා දෙන මේට ශක්තියක් වෙලා මේ ශක්තියම සමාජ දෙවරක් බවට හරවපු කෙනාව කැඳවන්න තමයි මේ සුදුසුම මොහොත.
Definitely as far as said, ladies and gentlemen, now it's time to get an understanding of the research, the idea behind carrying out such a program to improve the vision of the nation. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the program director of iCare, optometrist Naresh Pradhan, to give you all an insight in to iCare 2016.
Distinguished guests, especially Dr. Amila Diyalis, Dr. Meena Kumar Das, Dr. Aismantha, Dr. Asila Abidire, and other guests, other faculties, Mr. Thirina and all others, and my parents and especially my students and other organizations who is representing today. And especially what I'm going to talk to you about is what is ICAR 2016 and what we are going to do in 2016 and what is happening, right? So actually, you know, there are some tentative program has been changed, and there are some, you know, these things are there, but still it has to be continued because there are some delays happening, so which we don't, you know, we will not be afforded to, so then we are continuing as it is. So then ICAR 2016, you know, as we have done ICAR 2010, then after that we have, you know, every 2 years we have, you know, these consecutive programs like 2010, then 2014, then 2016. So this is our, you know, third major program that we have been conducting. And especially what happens in ICAR 2016, we have a motto of community for ICAR. So to say ICAR for community, where we will be more focusing our activities on community-based program. So that is what, you know, so there will be a lot of programs which we will be, you know, organizing with different NGOs as well as government organizations, which we have done in past and which will be more exaggerated. And especially about, you know, now ICAR just completed 9 years old, and last 28 January, actually, my teacher Dasanta Fonseca's birthday is on 28 January, so on his birthday only I started ICAR, and on, you know, this completes 9 years. On the occasion of 9 year, actually we had a symbol of, okay, lighting the lamp at 8 o'clock everywhere in the country. So not only within the country, actually, you know, this happened in Jaffna, this happened in Anuradhapura, this happened in Kandy, this happened in down south, this happened in Colombo, Kandy. It had not only in Buddhist temples, it happened in church, Muslim, mosques, you know, all Hindu temples and also the flip. And it has gone beyond to that. Our students who are in Kenya, people who are in Dubai, people who are in Maldives, you know, they have also, you know, lightened their lamp, and there are few pictures that I'm showing you. And exactly 8 means, you know, in Kenya it becomes about, you know, something 5:30 in the morning. So they have reached, and then so a similar kind of program that has been done by Yashwant Soshi and those people to support us in India and Nepal Optometrist Association in Nepal. So they, I'm very much thankful to them who has devoted that time for, you know, so on our request that they have reached to those points and did these activities. So especially what happens, ICAR with a lot of version, in a sense, when we started in 2007, actually we never thought we will be one day giving a diploma or one day we will be giving a certificate which will be recognized by the by the government of Sri Lanka. We have never thought of when we started. And it was just an upgrading program that we wanted to do for officials. And fortunately, you know, we met Mr. Wazir Abdulla, and we managed to, you know, engage with Tertiary Education Commission. And then we started developing national competitive standard, and we were gradually, you know, as per the demand, it was increasing. So today, actually, with lot of reforms and lot of changes, today we are doing diploma, which is actually, you know, so generally diploma is a 2 years program, but our program runs for almost 4 years. And because of, you know, so most of, you know, the people who comes to us doesn't have a background of bioscience or the science background, and then what happens, we go for as a foundation program for first year, then second year for certificate in optometry, and then third and fourth year as a diploma. So then if somebody who has, you know, science background, then they directly enter to the second year, and then they do, you know, second year, third year and fourth year program. So as it is a part-time program, and so within 3 months of time, whoever has engaged to the program who does not have optical background, they are engaged into the optical industry, and so that they can have their practical as much as possible. So beyond the ICAR Institute, actually, you know, 2011, we managed to develop ICAR Optometry Association to have a, you know, a lot of welfare activities for our students. Then beyond that, what happens, we made network. Then we made a community ICAR center where our students could have our own practical center. Because the very first we were using Lions Hospital at Padavata. Then later on what happened, we thought, why not start our own. Then today what happens, the student who enters to our program, they enter as a student. Then once they finish their program, they enroll in our association as a member.
And once they enroll into the membership, then they can enroll into different organizations as well, like Ceylon Council of Optometry and all of them. Then after that, once they establish themselves into a certain standard, they can apply for the network, and then that network works from at the moment. It works everywhere, like we have in Jaffna, we have in Abilipitiya, we have in Matra, we have in Gaul, we have in Gampaha, Colombo, wherever. So this facilitates the customers or the public is facilitated by that program, where if you purchase or you have taken a service from Colombo, you can get, you know, so post service in any part of the country. So then what happens, the community eye care center, which we are right now focusing more, and so hopefully, you know, this year we will be expanding that program. So this is how it looks like, our program, you know. So this is where we go, and then very first the people who can enter to our courses are like people who has O level or has a 5 years of experience, right? Then after that they enter to second year program, certificate program, then they enter to diploma program. So that is how at the moment it is working. And our diploma, which if they complete our diploma, now Sengi University Malaysia, they accept as into the, you know, they allow them to go to the, you know, lateral entry. In India, like L.V. Prasad and Bharati Vidyapeeth University accept the lateral entry for our students. And so we, because of, at the critical point of Sri Lankan, for some reason, you know, in South Asia, actually in Asia, the first optometry education was started in Sri Lanka, but still we don't have BSc program. And Kenya, we have supported them to develop diploma, and now they are starting from this year the degree program. So we have supported Pakistan people, they come and learn at eye hospital as a student, and now they have master's program. So that's unfortunate, but hopefully, you know, things are getting better, and hopefully in future, you know, we may have this sort of a programs. So meantime, ICA institutes or the ICA organization involves in various things, like say school exhibition program, individually ourselves, or we work with Vision 2020, or we work with Hope for the Children, or we work with Brian Golden Vision Institute, or other So Others May See, or different kind of Lions Club International, or sort of thing. And we do this training for the teachers, like sort of semi-government and government and the private school, where we do training for them. You know, free training for the schools, and that they can, you know, assist the children, or they can at least refer the children to the you know, specialist. And so then we do the social worker trainings. So there are a lot, like we have almost 24 NGOs functioning with us at the moment, and that's in